Hi you guys, back again with another video, and I will be reacting to Kevin Hart, Cold as Ball. He has Nerlens Noel featured on here. I hope I'm saying his name right, but he has him featured on here. So without further ado guys, let's get into the video.
Comedic rock star. A part of living that rock star life is having a bunch of friends that are athletes. They're busy, I'm busy. Being they were all so busy, the only way I can talk to these people is right here in this ice bag.
So serious.
Welcome to Coldest Balls. Today's episode, I'm sitting down with my guy, Nerlens Noel. All right. See, you went with a generic basketball bottle.
Let's get right in. Don't waste no time. Let's get right in.
Brother, I don't need you to tell me what to do. I know what I got to do.
That water looks
super cold. First of all, Mark Cuban, man. Let's talk about Mark for a sec. What are you expecting to get from Mark that you didn't get in Philadelphia?
I'm expecting to get a lot of games.
You know? Locker room's a lot better.
Oh, yeah. It's a little better.
They say y'all got everything.
Yeah, it's an upgrade. It's an upgrade, for sure.
Philadelphia, you saying we didn't have shit?
Yeah.
He feels some type of way about that.
Ones over here.
See, that's cool. The problem. That's the problem in Philadelphia. We don't have enough shit in the locker room. Look how excited this man just got talking about we got Xbox One. He ain't say shit about the weight room. He's talking about the Xbox.
Dip it in. Come on, Kevin.
I thought that
come
was
on, Kevin. Dip it in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good,
that's
man.
Comfortable.
Yeah.
He was a crazy kid, crazy city kid.
No. I was a good kid, but you know, everything around you can, you know, really
can influence what you're doing.
Most definitely.
No, so you're basically trying to talk around the fact that you had friends that was assholes. You had bad influences.
Yeah.
I did that so you can understand, and I'm gonna ask you the tough questions on Cold as Ball.
Play too much.
Don't run away from these questions.
I ain't running from no questions, Kevin.
What players do you think you have little pieces of?
The player I really look up to, you know, especially being from Boston, is Bill Russell.
Bill Russell, the oldest man in the world.
He's not mine.
How old is Bill Russell?
Bill Russell.
Bill Russell got to be 300.
Shut up. That man ain't that old.
83? That's bullshit. He's 183. If you ever say a wrong answer and make me look stupid on my show again, you're fired. And you can go fuck yourself.
Lord.
Sorry you had to hear that.
It's all good, man. It's Bill Russell.
You and KG almost made being tall and skinny cool.
I think it is pretty cool.
No. Y'all.
You almost are getting to the point where being a midget is pretty
cool. Oh, shit. Hard. He's not a midget.
First of all, we don't use the word midget on this show. We use the correct term as little people. Second of all, I'm petite.
Boy, please.
Petite. You was not petite. Which is a masculine way of saying short. Yeah. University of Kentucky. A lot of legends then came to Kentucky. You consider yourself one of the legends come to Kentucky?
I definitely feel like I'm one of the legends, one of the alpha dogs that came through there.
Alpha dog.
It's
funny, because I got recruited.
You got recruited?
Yeah.
Boy, please.
University of Kentucky. I'm not sure, you were probably young. It was a little thing, but I turned him down. The program wasn't for
Kevin
me.
Kevin Hart, be friend.
I could have went down that same pipeline. I chose a different route. I chose stand-up comedy, but if I had chose basketball, I would have went to the University of Kentucky. We would have both been alpha dogs. We would have been two alpha dogs in a hot cold tub. Do you consider yourself a ladies' man?
I consider myself a gentleman.
Yep, all basketball players.
Why you go to R&B?
I about the ladies.
Why you just switched to R&B just now?
Why you just switched to R&B?
Just changed. We was talking and you said, I don't consider you. I consider myself a gentleman. You got a female right now?
I do.
Well, how long you been together? How long you and Lady been together?
We've been.
That boy damn near choked.
And he can't get it out.
So give me some advice on, you know, your love life and, you know.
Relationship advice?
Yes, sir. I need that.
You know. A happy woman is a happy home. Mm-hmm. Happy wife, happy life. That's what I believe in. You know, just say yes.
Yep. Someone just say yes.
Mm-hmm. Will do. Mm-hmm. Yes, I can. What'd you say? Got it. Done. Ha! Coming right up. What'd you need me to do? I'm on it. Ha! You want me to go right now? See that? That's just a plethora of the word
like
yes.
That. I'm gonna take that.
Do that, bro. Who's the biggest asshole that you played against?
Biggest asshole?
Yeah.
Dang.
Biggest asshole.
My God, DeMarcus. He's my
DeMarcus?
Homie. He's that asshole.
He wears very tight jeans.
Not an asshole. Play too much. Like, too late.
He said it. I agree. DeMarcus, you're an asshole.
He's an asshole.
Kevin Hart started
stuff.
DeMarcus, he feels like you're
an asshole. Oh, yeah, he started stuff.
On your team, okay? Biggest asshole now that you moved to Dallas that you think that you're going to do. What about
Dirk? Dirk is a good ass dude.
He's a good dude?
I mean, he's just as funny as you, honestly.
There's no way he's funny as me. Or as funny as me. That's impossible.
No, he'd probably sell out. He'd probably sell out.
Because he said it. He's probably funny as you.
No,
it's actually impossible.
No, I'm dead serious.
Ready to go all the way in, Kev?
What are you talking about?
You going all the way in.
Oh, he taking the seat out. Kevin Hart never take his little stool out.
I don't answer a man when he look me in the eye and say, you ready to go all the way? What are you talking about? I don't know what you think this show is, but that's not what we do here. Okay? So I don't know what happens in the locker room at Kentucky and these things, but it ain't going to happen on this show.
He played to
what? What you wearing? The size 36? What size is she? Jesus Christ.
It's not bad.
Oh, my God.
Definitely got some 18s, 19s. I hit
Jesus.
Dang.
God. Now, even though you left Philadelphia, I definitely got a lot of questions about Philly. You know, like I said, that's my hometown. Like the face of Philadelphia, man. Joel Embiid, was he sad to see you go?
Yeah, that was tough, man.
Can you try to say like one of the sentences where he can't really finish all the words?
No, it's okay. It's okay, you know, things happen.
You play too much.
The process.
Say the fucking sentence, man. We're at dinner. I'm spitting all over the food and everything.
So I'm gonna ask you some questions now, see how well, since you know you got a nice little feel for what I'm about. What pick was I in the NBA draft?
Easy question. Number
38. 38? Kev.
Yeah.
Kev, come on, Kev. Hmm? First round.
First round, you went number one. He went number one!
What position do I play?
Power forward, more in the center. Because you rotate.
See, Kev, you're doing a lot. It's running around.
I'm not running around. I'm telling the truth. Because in the NBA, they change it. You're center.
He don't know.
Ha, that's the right. Get your
it had to do
that.
It don't faze me,
dog. Yeah, well, you don't have somebody that obviously has it out for you. I'm dealing with a full-blown racist over here.
No, he didn't.
You obviously don't like black people. Cat's out the bag now, ain't it? Jesus Christ. All right, here's a question for you. If you weren't playing basketball, what would you be doing in general?
In life? I was going to be an FBI agent.
FBI agent. Really?
Well, it wouldn't be no secret.
See,
he's too tall.
A tall FBI. There you go. No, you're talking about the guy in the trench coat. He's an FBI agent. What would I be doing? I'd probably be a thug.
Boy, please.
I was always a killer.
Kevin Hart's really hard.
I probably back to killing. Because I was a cold motherfucking killer in my heyday. As these, if you don't believe me.
My favorite celebrity,
I'd have to go Will Smith.
Will Smith.
He's on Will
Philadelphia. It's just weird when we got a...
Not you, Kev.
Guy that you're sitting right across from that you've been talking to. Could have easily said me and I would. Taken back by if you chose Will. I get it. Who else? Give me one more.
One more?
Favorite comedian.
Who do you think is? Chris Rock.
Okay.
He's doing it on purpose.
When I say
okay, guys, that was Kevin Hart, Cold as Ball. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video, and please do not forget to subscribe.